Ooh, look at that.
Oh my gosh, I can't wait to show Jonathan when he gets up. He's gonna freak out.
Kat and I are back in the woods again, and she's over there getting bug proof. But last time we were here was the beginning of the year, and we discovered two incredible mastodon teeth, along with an incredible assortment of both Miocene and Pleistocene fossils. So we're here again for the first time in a while. Kat's prepared to be looking through fossils again on this table, and I'm gonna get my scuba gear. I'm gonna jump in there and bring you guys some amazing history. Next time you see me, I will have fossils for you. So one of the things we love doing at Digging Science is education. So this bone right here is a piece of a mammoth or mastodon skull, and we can tell that that's what it is by this honeycomb structure. And this honeycomb structure would have allowed the mammoth or mastodon skull to still stay rigid, but reduce its weight. So all throughout this skull, this webbing would have existed, these air pockets that would have allowed the skull to reduce weight. Now even though it had this adaptation, their brain still would have been huge. And our brains use about 10% of our calorie use per day. So you can just imagine how many calories and how much grass it took to run a mammoth or mastodon brain. It's really incredible. So I'm gonna get back in that hole and hopefully we can find some more awesome pieces of history. That is a mastodon vert. So I'm gonna go grab it, bring it back up, and then we'll be able to see what shape it is in, if it's whole or not. I'm really excited to go grab that. It's a really cool bone. That is a large and very cool mastodon or mammoth vert. I'm guessing mastodon based off what we found here before. If you look at this little joint right there, that's where the animal's rib would have attached. So you can just imagine a vertebral column with ribs that were easily that long coming from this animal. So that's a really cool bone. It's probably more like that in there. I'm gonna go see what I can grab. Ooh, love this history. Ooh.
Look at all that.
Yep, there you go. It's a piece of a horse tooth. So good ice age stuff in this trap. I'm gonna get back in there. I'll let Kat go through this so she can add some more fossils to the collection and hopefully see what's in here to show you. Oh, that's ivory. That's a big piece of ivory, actually. Let me wash this off. That is so cool. So that's ivory. Let's check the Schreger lines. Mastodon. So they have these lines in it. They're called Schreger lines. I don't know if you can get a good shot of it with the camera. See them right there?
Stop wiggling.
I'm trying not to wiggle. But that's how you can identify this as ivory. So normally you don't have this preserved because it's not nearly as hard as enamel. But that is a good large portion of extinct mastodon or mammoth ivory. So there's a lot of cool Ice Age stuff in here. I can't wait to see what else we can find today.
So this is pretty cool. This horse tooth we just found is pathological. So you see how normally the lines in the enamel will go straight down. They're parallel, but this one is curved. It's got a little curve right there. So this horse tooth was a little crooked. So that's pretty cool. So we just got this nice gator tooth. They're a little wider and fatter than crocodile teeth. That's a pretty nice one. Kind of has like a shape of a small bullet. It's really cute. And here he is with our next one. We saw, we've got a lot of gravel to go through.
Ooh, look at that. Oh my goodness.
So I was just sifting and look at that, look at that, look at that. Oh my gosh, look at those beautiful roots. I believe this is a tapir tooth. That is a gorgeous complete tooth. Oh my gosh, I can't wait to show Jonathan when he gets up. He's gonna freak out. What did we just find?
That is one of the nicest tapir teeth I have ever seen. So we had tapirs in Florida, Tapirus veroensis, and a few other species as well. And they were larger than the modern tapir, which lives in South America. But they were like pigs with elephant noses. So if you can imagine a large pig, and just give it a little elongated nose, and their babies are so cute. But that's what this animal would have been. I found jaws and before, but I've never found a tooth, isolated tooth with a full root. Well, technically,
look at the color on that root. That is beautiful.
Museum quality. I am very happy. It's from the lower jaw as well. Great occlusal wear. Awesome find. Makes me want to get back in that water so bad. So here is that incredible camel tooth I just found underwater. Really awesome tooth, perfect chewing surface. Would have been a young one. The roots aren't fully developed, but gosh, that is an awesome example of an extinct Ice Age camel from this area. So we have another awesome fossil right here. Yep, that is an incredible horse tooth. So that's the roots. It's an old horse. Let me wash this off.
You almost lost me.
But here's the chewing surface. Each one of these little ripples, let's get in the sun. Those ripples are enamel bands. They're used to graze and grind down grass. Very similar to a mammoth. Down here, this is the roots. So horse teeth start off as really long teeth. And over time, they grind them down to these nubs. So this would have been from a very old adult horse. That's a really cool find. So this is really impressive. This is a juvenile, either a camel or llama tooth. It's unerupted, so if you look at the crown, it has no wear yet. So it's kind of hard to tell exactly what it is. We'll have to do more research to figure out what species it is, but it's either a camel or llama, Florida camel or llama. That's a really awesome piece of history. And then right next to it was this juvenile tooth.
Right, here's that tooth. I honestly have very little idea to what this could be. If you guys know or think you know what it is, please let me know in the comments below. It's not rodent. It's definitely from a larger animal. But the tooth is really small. It also doesn't have really any wear at all. It's a really unique tooth. I'm really excited to see what this is. I might have to talk to Dr. Holbert at the University of Florida Natural History Museum. But I love finding stuff like this. These small mysteries are really what make this an awesome hobby. All right, I'm gonna get back in that hole. Just had lunch, find some more fossils.
This isn't easy work, but it's rewarding.
Tooth right there.
Once again, cat's got me going to work. Might be hard to see, but that's another awesome mammal tooth. I think that's probably deer. It's got a really awesome chewing surface, but it's a premolar, so right in the front. There is so much diversity in this hole. That's incredible. Another awesome Ice Age fossil right there.
This is not something we see every day. This is a modern gator tooth. So unlike the tooth that we pulled out earlier, it was black. This one is bright white. So definitely something we see every day. Obviously, we know that gators do inhabit these rivers, and that is a risk that we take every time we go into them. So check out our modern gator tooth that I just found next to this giant fossil gator tooth. that Jonathan just pulled out of the sift. Pretty incredible size difference.
Okay, first two tiger shark teeth of the day. The one on the left here came out of the gravel pile. And the one on the right, Jonathan just brought up in his net from underwater.
And I'm gonna go get some more.
So I don't know, I think mine is prettier, but yours is a little bigger.
Hey you wanna fight? You wanna fight? You wanna fight?
Yeah, fight me. Let's do this.
No, my tiger shark will kick your tiger shark's butt.
It's debatable.
Yeah, I was digging around and I see just the bottom of a tooth. Looks like a gator tooth. So uncover. Wow, look at that. It has a wicked curve and a beautiful point.
So that is a crawfish. There are a couple hundred species of them, most of them native to the southeastern United States. The ones we have in Florida are a bit smaller than the ones we eat in Louisiana, but they are an awesome little crustacean. And they are delicious, but this one we will not eat. We'll give them back to the river. I think you guys all know what that is. That is another beautiful tiger shark tooth. Love these sharks. Love finding their teeth. And let's put it on top of this awesome turtle scute. Very cool.
Is you getting tired?
Bleh. Yeah, I'm getting tired.
Me too.
We'll get home and get some food soon.
Yes.
Ooh. So I'm getting ready to push the gravel back into this little water section over here, and I uncovered this amazing canine that is extinct camel canine. So this isn't a llama or anything else or a predator. The camels we had in Florida had these insane canines. So that is pretty awesome. An extinct Florida canine. My first one. Arr. That's so cool.
Ooh, look at all the stuff we found. Ooh.
Broken.
So nice. Ooh.
What you doing?
So nice. Check that out.
It was an incredibly good day for rare finds. Let's start with the last find of the day. That is an incredible camel canine. So camels have these insidious looking canines. This species is obviously extinct. It's native to Florida in the southeast, and it is my first one. You can see the enamel line starts right here, and there would have come up. I can't imagine being a herbivore and having canines that mean looking. Next tooth for today was this gorgeous tapir tooth. I have not seen one come out of the river that's perfectly rooted like this in a very long time, so I am very happy that Cat managed to save this one from the screen. Beautiful chewing surface, great color, and literally perfect from the extinct tapir, probably Tapirus veroensis. Latin's not my strong suit, but that's an awesome piece of history. And then we've got, let's see, some llama teeth. So that is a llama tooth that is unerupted. Gorgeous little guy. Doesn't have any roots yet and has no wear to the surface, but that is an extinct Florida llama. We've got fossilized deer teeth right there. Another camel tooth right here. It's a beautiful one. Great chewing surface. Beautiful colors. Our extinct horses that we find pretty commonly. And then we've got gator teeth. Cat managed to find some big ones like this chonker. We've got another thick boy over here. Some more gracile gator teeth like this one right here. And then we even managed to find a modern gator tooth, which I think is really cool. Rather find their teeth than ones attached to a live one. What do you think about that?
Yeah.
But it was a really awesome day. This kind of diversity is incredible. It really represents how Florida was one of the best spots for Ice Age mammals. So during the Pleistocene, during the last glacial maximum, the last Ice Age, Florida was a savanna. It wasn't heavily wooded like it is now. Some areas were, but we had tigers, lions, camels, cheetahs, tapirs. Oh my, right? Mammoths, mastodons, and this spot is a great representation of these extinct animals. It's really cool to see all of this diversity, representation of animals that used to be here in Florida, and you'd only think of living on the savanna. Camels, llama, deer, extinct tapir, extinct horses, really diverse spot. Very thankful that we were able to come out here and find some awesome fossils. And we are gonna go get some food. Thank you guys so much for watching. If you enjoyed the video, please like, share, subscribe. And I can't wait to bring you guys the next video of us finding this awesome history. So, take care.